really young team, 3-6, and obviously in the offseason we took a look in the mirror and just said, okay, hey, what's going to work for us next year, looking at our personnel, and we knew we were going to be a team that had veteran leadership on defense and great special teams, and we were looking to capitalize on offense, and we said, well, what's the best way for us to move the ball, and then we looked at, you know, creating some more RPOs and utilizing our quarterback as an athlete to move the chains, something that we struggled with mightily last year.
Now, young man here, the quarterback, he's only started the last two games last year, right?
That is correct.
Wow, so did you know that? Because he said he was a tight end before. And,
well, it really clicked the second half of the Gilman game. I believe that score, it might have been maybe 0-0, but it was a close game going into halftime against Gilman. And then we were able to capitalize in the second half. Using what you're seeing now, letting press a bit athlete, letting him create with his feet and his big arm and making some big plays for us. And we're built to be a more big play team. Obviously, we still have the running game, but in these MIA conference battles, everyone's got a great defense, everyone's got good special tapes, so it's all up for us. It's all about how can we have sustained success and get the change.
Talk about, they blocked that punt, they're down on the three. Talk about that defensive stand.
Well, it was great. I mean, obviously, Jackson Bonnets, he's been doing it for a long time. And we dialed up a blitz for him to go right through the middle.
That's right, that last play.
And Bonnets really, really set the tone there. And he's been doing it for a while. You know, he's a lacrosse kid, but football's in his heart. He's a beast.
Lacrosse kid with football in his heart. That's a good combination.
4-for-7, 90 yards passing.
You did a nice job on shutting down 24 for
Sean Tucker. He's an unbelievable back on Syracuse. When you look at him, that was really the challenge this week. Going into it, we say, hey, how can we stop 24? And last year, when you looked at the tape against Calvert Hall, our defensive ends didn't do a great job of containing their gaps. And that was something we really worked on all week. Because he has the ability to bounce. He's very shifty.
Yeah.
And he breaks tackles. So we knew one guy could not tackle him by himself. So the message all week was, hey, we got to have gap integrity, and then we got to rally to the ball. If we can do that, we'll have success.
And number 33, is he hurt?
He's fine. He was cramping up. He was cramping up. Yep.
Okay.
Yep.
Okay. So gap integrity was a big thing for Tucker.
Yes.
Coach, you're off to a 6-0 start.
Thank you.
Could you imagine this before the season?
No, we were just trying to get 1-0 after last year. Capitalize off of the offseason workout plan. And we were just looking. I think after our first couple of scrimmages, we were looking and say, okay, hey, guys, how can we move the ball? We knew we were going to have great defense and have great special teams. So we had to make a decision and obviously figure out, okay, what is our identity going to be on the offensive end?
And that's your quarterback and the RPOs?
RPO, and running the ball with Giovanni.
Is it Giovanni? Yeah,
yeah, he's a tough guy. Tough.
Yes, he is. Back there. He's not that big of a kid, but he's. Yeah. Thanks for your time.
Hey, thank you. Congratulations. I appreciate it. Thank you.